Are your stirrups too long? Are they too short? What actually is the right length for our stirrups? In today's video, I'm here with Caitlin and with her horse Tizzy, and we're gonna give you both a simple answer to this as well as a few easy tips to determine your stirrup length, as well as the more full answer as to what really is a good stirrup length. So the full answer is that your stirrup length is going to vary depending on what you're doing, depending on the saddle that you're riding, the activity and the discipline that you're doing with your horse. The simple answer is that for riding in a close contact saddle, like Caitlin is here, if we go ahead and take her foot out of the stirrup and we let her leg just hang down, the stirrup should meet her leg right about at the center of her ankle. If she was riding in a Western saddle, that stirrup would be just at the bottom of the ankle. Now, where this gets a little bit more of the full answer, as I said earlier, is our stirrup length is really dependent on the activity that we're doing. What that means is that if Caitlin was riding Tizzy in a dressage test and a really advanced frame, her upper body would be really upright, and that would mean that she would need a longer stirrup length so that her thigh was angled more down and that her ankle stayed underneath of her center. Now, if she was jumping, she would be angling more forward. The bigger that the fence got, the more of a forward fold she would have, and the more that this stirrup would have to go up to a shorter height in order to accommodate her body going forward and her hips going back. That's why when you look at jumping saddles or cross-country saddles, they've got that really big, big cut of the forward flap in order to accommodate the shorter stirrup and the leg going forward. Now, a really good way to find the length of your stirrup, a little trick, is to put your fingers right at the top of the stirrup bar, bring the stirrup down, and notice where the bottom of the stirrup, where your foot rests here on the stirrup, where that hits you. For most people, it's going to hit you about in your armpit. What you can do is you can start to notice exactly where the bottom of that stirrup hits for your normal length, for the activity that you're doing. And then if you're riding in different saddles, if other people ride in your saddle, you can do that little test and get the stirrup pretty close to where you need it. Sometimes if you're riding in a used saddle, if you've had your saddle in your stirrup leathers for a long time, or if you're riding in school saddles that have also had a good bit of life and wear to them, these stirrup leathers can start to get a bit stretched out, meaning they won't always be completely even on both sides. So you might put them in the fourth hole down on both sides, but it's not totally even. So a little trick that you can do is you can take the stirrup, fold it up, and notice the space between the footrest of the stirrup and the bottom of your saddle flap. Of course, this is a trick that just works on the English saddles, but when you do that, then you can compare on either side, and it's a really good way to make sure that your stirrups are even regardless of just what hole they're on. So what can happen if you ride with your stirrup too short for what you're doing is that you're going to feel like you're just a little jammed up and riding like a jockey. It can also take the weight off of your thigh and force more weight into your heel if you're riding, again, too short for what you're doing. If you're getting ready to jump around, you need to have this short length. However, what can also happen is if you're riding with a stirrup too long, is you might have to start reaching with your toe in order to try to keep a hold of the stirrup. You lose the length through your calf, and you might find that the stirrup swings more. You're not able to keep it as steady. So again, we want to find the stirrup length that, regardless of what you're doing, we're keeping your ankle underneath the center of mass of your body. Sitting here, it's underneath of the hip joint. In movement, that can change. For example, in jumping and forward fold, the center of mass is changed because we're folded forward. It's no longer right over the hip, but our weight still needs to be over our feet, over our ankle. Also, a big function of having a good stirrup length is that it allows for movement in these three important joints of the leg: the ankle, the knee, and the hip. These are our shock absorbers when we're moving, and we want these joints to be able to move fluidly so that you're able to go with the movement of the horse and you're able to stay soft within that movement. I hope that you found these quick tips helpful. scroll down and leave a comment and tell me, is there another riding tip or a riding question that you have that you would love to see a video on? As always, thank you so much for watching, and I look forward to your feedback and ideas for our next videos.